In this video, I will show you how to create a purchase order manually in Ongoing. I will show you where you can make an Excel import of purchase orders, although I won't do it. And I will show you how the system can generate a purchase order suggestion using the reorder point for an article that you have. The purchase order list is here, and you reach it from order and then purchase order list. You have the usual search functionalities. You can update your purchase orders. You can get the purchase order note, which I will show you. You have some function here, some functions attached to these buttons that if you want to receive goods and get your traceability, you can do so here. You can expand the purchase order. You can add a new row if you want. You can edit it. It'll take you to a different page. We won't do it now, but just so you know. And also, when you come to pages like this, you quite often in Ongoing have this show all fields where you have more information to put in, but it's not necessarily so that you need it for your particular logistics flow. We'll go back to the purchase order list and let's create a new one. So you go to order and then create purchase order. Here you can, the only thing that is actually required, it's a purchase order number. Let's do it with the purchase order number 10. And let's put in ref, 100. And we are gonna select a supplier and then we can only order from that particular supplier on the purchase order. So click create. And here now you see that we only have, these are the goods that the Oakley wholesaler is providing. So let's say we're only going to order from them. And we are here, we can see how much we have in stock. And I'll put in 100 more of these, or let's put in 1,000 more of these shorts. And I'll just press enter or click that button. And now you see I have 1,000 shorts on its way here. And then here I will put 1,000 more, and here I can close my order, and now I have a purchase order number here with this purchase order number, and here's the ref 100 that I put in. And I did not put in a inbound date, but that is not necessary. Here it's status notified now. I can click this button and then I can print the PDF out of this one by clicking that button. And I can, for example, we know we have many customers that do this, that they just create the purchase order in here and then they email it to their supplier. This is what I want to order. And then the same purchase order ID is hopefully used then by the supplier when he or she sends the goods to you, and then you can match it to the purchase order that you have already created. Next thing to show is how you can generate a purchase order suggestion using the reorder point. So let's first go and create an article, and I go to warehouse and article, create new article. Here I can also edit the existing ones, but to make it completely clear, let's create a new one and let's call it hoodie, like that, with article number hoodie medium. And here you see that you have a reorder point and min reorder quantities. So I'm going to put reorder point. So whenever we go under 200 in stock for this hoodie, then we are going to try and reorder. And if you use this purchase order suggestion that I will show you, and we can put in 50 here, that's a min reorder quantity. So if we go under 200 and then let's say 190 and then use this suggestion that I will show you, it'll bump up to it'll order the min 50. So let's create that one. Now you see I have 0 in stock here, and we are gonna attach it to the supplier. Let's see, where do we have that? Here, Oakley wholesaler. Click update, and then now when I go to create a purchase order from supplier Oakley, and let's put 11 here to create. And now you can see that I have the possibility to order also hoodies and these goods that you saw before. And here is the button that generate purchase order suggestion, and that will use the reorder point. So we are definitely under 200, and then the min quantity is 50. So now we're gonna bump it up to 200 when I click that. So here we get 200 as a suggestion. And note also, had we had any incoming purchase order on its way, then those would be counted as well. So I click here, and then I have this hoodie on the way. And we also have another option here that you can talk to your ongoing rep about. It's called the delivered since setting, and you can read about that in our docs. So we close the order, and now we have a purchase order with also 200 hoodies coming in. Now, of course, this is how you create the purchase order manually, but typically you might have some software integration to another system to generate these purchase order. It could be Visma, could be Inventory Planner, could be Fort Knox, or any other system that you might use in your business. But this is how you would create one manually. Yes, the final thing, just to show you where you would, if you would do it through Excel, you go to registers and then import and then purchase order. Without going into full detail on how you do the Excel import for multiple purchase orders, I will refer you to our docs page on the topic. It's available at docs.ongoingwarehouse.com/manual/Excel import. Here's an excellent guide on how you in general import data from Excel to Ongoing. So that's it for this video. Thank you very much.